We'll definitely stop and have a look at the giraffe then. Have you just got one? Looks like one just for now. See if I can see any other tall heads. The giraffe is just hiding behind the tree. So camouflaged. There's also lots of elephant tracks around here, but they are not going in the direction that I wanted to go. And like I said, I'm not tracking any animals. We're just going to bump into them. Hello, giraffe. You look very hungry. This is quite cool, actually, because this giraffe has just got its head tucked into the trees. And just from looking at it straight away, it is a female. But there's actually a few other giraffes here too, so hopefully they'll feed in the same direction that this lovely young lass is feeding in, which means straight towards our car. Isn't that cool? I did not think we were going to see giraffe today, so this is a surprise to me. It's quite a pleasant surprise, in fact. It's very nice, and I'm sure that they are also enjoying the warmth. Luckily for the giraffe, they don't need to climb to the tops of the trees to warm themselves up. They're tall enough that normally the first ray of light actually probably pierces that of the giraffe's eyes. Might have to put their sunglasses on first thing in the morning. Now, good morning, Inca. You said that you're very excited to see the giraffe. Well, that's good, because our giraffe are about to multiply, but we'll wait till the others come out of the thicket. This is the nicest view. Now, yesterday we were talking quite a bit about knobthorns and their flowers and various animals that pollinate them, and I'd mentioned that the giraffes are pollinators and that their diet consists normally of knobthorns and any of the other acacia species, but this one is not feeding off of an acacia at the moment. It is eating a bush willow. Is that delicious? Seems to be delicious. She's barely stopped to breathe since we've got here. Now, good morning, Nancy. I can't say Nancy. I have to tell you, Nancy, let me tell you a very quick story before I even answer your question. It's so funny. My car has got the name Nancy too, and it's one of my favorite names in the whole wide world. Look at this, Craig. Look at this youngster walking towards us. So your question is, how do I know it's female? So we'll get back to that one. Let me show you how to identify a giraffe that's not hiding behind the trees. Now, this is a young giraffe, so it's obviously mom and offspring. Only a couple of years old. Now, just from looking at it, I can't see the little bump on the belly that normally indicates a male giraffe, but also it's walking at a strange angle, so it may reveal itself. Its ossicones look of normal size, but they do have very fluffy tips on them. You can see that. But that you can't use when a giraffe is this young, because even a young boy would have very fluffy ossicones. It's only once they get a little bit older. So I'm going to say that this is a female, just from the angle that we're looking at. So, what are they seeing? See, both mom and youngster just staring off into the distance. Now, because giraffe are so much taller than us and all the animals out here, it's important that we pay attention to what they're looking at, because they'll see things far away. They've got exceptional eyesight. Yes, it is a little girl. So, basically, isn't we just check? It's so difficult to see. No, I think it is. It is a girl. And Judy, you say you love their eyelashes. Me too. I think ostriches, giraffe, and southern ground hornbill, particularly, have the most beautiful eyelashes. And you can see that little red-billed oxpecker is getting too close for comfort there. And I love the way that they work their beaks. You see how they almost do a very like scissor-like motion through the hair? So they're not pulling off big ticks. They're actually going for the tick larvae and the much smaller ticks, the pepper ticks, the ones that we hate the most on bushwalk, the ones that look like freckles on your skin. That's what they'll be going after. Whereas the yellow-billed hornbills, they tend to go for sort of the engorged ticks that you'll see around their nether regions, all those warm spots where ticks like to hang around. Very curious, this one too. So now standing, staring off into the drainage line. Let me see what you're looking at. Are you looking at elephants, perhaps? Well, there's a couple of things in the distance that look like they could be elephants, but they could also just be termite mounds too. Now, Dave, you're wondering if any predators could take down a giraffe, and if so, which ones? Now, there aren't many things that would be brave enough to tackle the tallest creature in the world, but lions have adapted very special skills to catching giraffes. Now, I haven't actually seen too many lions in the Sabi Sand taking down giraffe, except the Charleston males, which were two boys that came from Londolozi side and then moved south. And then they traversed in the southern section, southwestern corner of the Sabi Sand, but I believe they've moved into Kruger. They've taken down a fully grown giraffe before, just the two of them. It's very dangerous though. So in Namibia, also the lions, they specialize in going after giraffe. The whole thing about a giraffe is that it's actually not a very difficult animal to take down if you know what you're doing. Now, of course, I wouldn't have any clue on how to capture a giraffe because I'm not, well, really worried about going after one. But lions have to learn this, and eventually they learn. If you chase a giraffe over an area that is sort of unlevel and they trip and fall, they lose their footing and they slip, perfect moment to pounce, and they'll actually just jump onto their, well, towards their neck and pin them down like that, and then suffocate them. That's the best way. Otherwise, you have got to do a leap of faith, and you can imagine you get yourself in quite a bit of trouble if you're waiting for a giraffe that's running towards you and you decide to jump into the air and try and grab it around the chest. You run the risk of being chopped with those very powerful front feet, and those hooves are quite sharp too. And then if you try and tackle a giraffe from the rear end, which is typically what lions like to do, is take on their prey. They'll try and jump on their backs. You've got those two very powerful hindquarters. And if you get kicked by a giraffe and you end up getting a hoof to the face, you can break your jaw, can kill you instantly. You can suffer from internal bleeding. So it is a very, very dangerous decision to try, or for a lion to make, to go after a giraffe. The same thing goes for a buffalo. Lots of buffalo kill lions all the time. I'm trying to think. I wonder if there aren't... You see, now I think there are elephants down here, but I don't think you'll be able to see them. Because the thing that I thought... No, it's still there. Never mind. I was going to say it's moved, but it hasn't moved. But yes, then you get another position for the, of the giraffe. So it's just the two of them. Just scan down in this valley as we drive past. But even though something like a leopard is not necessarily anything for a giraffe to worry about, they do alarm at them. But a leopard wouldn't be able to take down a giraffe. It's too big. But if there's a giraffe carcass about, of course they would feed on it. They would not say no to that if there were no other predators around. I'm trying to think what else. Hyenas. Hyenas would harass young giraffe calves especially. They're particularly vulnerable. As with every other animal out here, when the female's given birth, most of these animals, it's just incredible how quickly they can jump to their feet. However, it does take half an hour sometimes, maybe even a little bit longer, depending on the individual. And then anything could come through and really snatch up a young giraffe calf, even a young elephant calf, a hippo calf. So that's where you'll find the hyenas will come in and be a particularly big problem. I think this is such a beautiful sighting, don't you? Birds all chirping, the sound of the giraffe stripping the leaves from the tree.